What exactly is Adobe Illustrator? Well, first and foremost, it's a graphics tool that can also be used for layout of type and images. But it's primarily known for the fact that it's a vector graphics tool. Now, a vector graphics tool is a graphics object that is described using code, and that code can then be passed on to other types of software or other devices, and the drawings executed and coded are then re-rendered on that other device's grid at that device's optimal resolution. So vector graphics are said to be resolution independent. The code can be passed on to a very low resolution device or an ultra high resolution device, and the low or the high resolution devices simply read the code and then render the graphics using that code using their own grid at whatever resolution that happens to be at. Now, I'm just going to start off by using the Ellipse tool, and I'm just going to hold the Option key to draw from center and the Shift key to keep it as a nice square. So I'm just going to draw that circle. I'm just going to fill it in red. So we'll give it a red fill. Currently it's adding it to the stroke. I'm going to swap this so that we have a red fill for that circle. Now, oftentimes it's better to understand something in terms of something else. So let's compare it with another type of program. This one is Adobe Photoshop. We're going to do exactly the same thing. I'm going to select red for my fill color, and then I'm going to use the Ellipse tool there and do exactly the same thing. Now, Photoshop is different insofar as it's a bitmap graphics tool, meaning it draws with pixels by turning them on, turning them off. And when you create a graphic using a bitmap graphics program like Photoshop, the resolution is said to be fixed. And so if you pass that off to a device, let's say a printer, that is of ultra high resolution, you won't be able to take advantage of that ultra high resolution because it simply tells it to fill in pixels that it has drawn rather than passing on a code. So let's just take a look at what this means in real terms. And for this, I'm just going to click down on the blank page and then use our zoom tool down here to zoom right into the edge. Now, as we really zoom in, you can see here that the edge of this graphic is actually pixelated, and that's showing the limiting resolution of the device on which we're creating this, in this case, the Macintosh screen. So you can actually see the individual pixels here. And even if I pass this information along to a grid of much higher resolution, it's still only able to resolve the graphic at this level of detail, at no finer detail. Now, in contrast, if we do the same thing in Illustrator, so let's use the zoom tool there, and we will zoom in, you will notice that there is no pixelation. As I increase the zoom and we drill in closer and closer, it re-renders that graphic using the code. And so it really has potentially an infinite resolution.